Hey guys, today I'm going to show you carvings like this. Yes, it looks like a human frog or a frogman. All these carvings I'm showing you today are from the 900-year-old Chennakesava temple. So you can understand why I'm calling this the frogman, because of how it is sitting, right? And its eyes are quite big, like that of a frog. But other than that, it is clearly wearing shoes and clothes, which makes me wonder, was it a genetically modified human like Spider-Man? Did ancient people experiment with genetic modification? Here's another strange one hiding in an inaccessible location. The body is definitely human, but what about the face? What animal is this? It clearly looks like a sheep or a goat, but the hairdo is very similar to the hairdo of the women shown in the other carvings of this temple. By looking at the body, we can clearly understand that this is a female and she's holding some strange pointy things in both her hands. So why did ancient builders carve these strange figures in this ancient temple? Most historians agree that sculptors carved what they saw. When they look at a beautiful carving like this, they say, oh, the sculptor must have seen a woman in this dancing posture. That's why he carved it. So, did the sculptors also see these genetically modified figures in ancient times? Did ancient builders know about genetic engineering? In this temple, unlike any other temple, there's a big corner dedicated to the Nagas, the serpentine gods. This whole area is full of Naga carvings. In the center, there is a giant female Naga with a seven-headed snake guarding her from the top. Locals are still worshiping her with flowers and saffron powder. Why? Because Naga is a symbol of fertility. Women without children come and worship the Nagas and hope the Naga will bless them with babies. And what's really interesting is that the entire wall is full of carvings reminding us of DNA strands, because these intertwined Nagas look very similar to the double helix structure of the DNA strands. And here you can see a bunch of sperm swimming, racing to fertilize the ovum to create more life. Is this all just a coincidence, or did ancient builders experiment with genetic modification? Here is a Naga figure holding a human in her lap. No, she's not holding a baby. She's holding a grown woman. Look at the fully grown breasts on that woman. And the Naga with her hood behind her head is shown much larger, holding the woman in her lap. Does it have anything to do with aliens interbreeding with humans? Or did ancient builders experiment with a mix of different species? Is this why they showed intertwining of various species? Behind this carving is another very strange carving. A man with a horse face is interacting with a woman. This sounds really interesting, because so far we saw the frogman and the goat woman just being alone. But now we can see this horse-faced man with a human female. Sorry about my shaky video. These weird figures are mostly carved in inaccessible locations, so I'm struggling to show them to you. Now, this is not the only horse-faced figure. There's a female with a horse face standing close to a man. It's safe to say that they're not just friends. And this carving is in a much more accessible location, so you cannot miss it. So if you visit this place, the tour guide will tell you that this carving was made to show you that love is blind. And when you're young, even a girl with a horse face will look attractive to you. But this theory is wrong. First, because look at her genitalia. It does not look like a woman's. It looks quite different from normal female genitalia. And two, because there are many statues which are standing alone, even horse face statues standing alone. The tour guides are spinning these theories because they don't know what is going on. Now, here's a figure that is much more human-like, but it is not fully human. Looks like a messed up genetic experiment between a human and some other ape like a gorilla. I say this because its arms are very long. The arms extend beyond the knees. Its head is kind of deformed with no hair on the head. And it has a very big, strong chest like a gorilla. And we know in the last 100 years, many countries have secretly tested human-ape hybrids. We have all heard of human Z, a hybrid of human and chimpanzee. And even though no government has openly admitted to this, many leaks confirm that several countries have tested these human-ape hybrids. Scientists confirm that humans are a little bit hybrid already. We have 2 to 3% of Neanderthal DNA in all of us. But the question is, did ancient civilizations also test other hybrids? Why else do we see such carvings of humans and animals combined? Here's another one that is completely mind-boggling. On the left, there is a very weak figure. You can see all his ribs as though he's ready to die. There is a tube going from this man's head onto this woman's thigh. It seems like the tube is sucking out all the blood from his body. He looks very skinny and completely emaciated. On the other side, this guy looks even more weird, wearing a long checkered coat. He's wearing boots too, like a modern day Westerner. And it appears that he's taking notes while the woman is standing there casually. Obviously, this reminds me of the movie Matrix, where Neo is connected to the tubes and he's struggling to come out of the Matrix. Are we living in a Matrix? I mean, is this life real? Is this base reality? Or are we living in a simulation or metaverse? Who can explain this crazy carving? Are we actually just hooked up to some kind of a strange device to our head, something implanted in our real physical body? And what we are experiencing is actually a simulation or virtual reality? Is this why ancient Hinduism called our life Maya or illusion? Here's something that looks very much like the Predator in the movie Predator. Its facial features are quite fearsome. You can see that it's wearing a striped suit. The suit extends all the way down to its ankle. It's holding plenty of different weapons and looks quite fantastic, right? Is it a predator? The key is the scorpion on the body. This is the key to identifying this figure. I told you ancient Indians practiced Mithridatism, which means they took snake or scorpion venom on a regular basis, which supposedly gradually altered their DNA. So they were able to transform into something else by taking slow doses of chemicals like neurotoxins. This was practiced by a cult that worshipped a specific type of Kali. I'm afraid to say more details because recently people have been targeting these statues and have been destroying them. I showed you how they destroyed another Kali statue in a previous video as well. Here's a mermaid-like figure. It's clear that it's a woman, and she's in a namaste pose, happily greeting us. But the lower half looks scaly and tapered like that of a fish. Is it a mermaid? Is it possible that mermaids exist? Right next to it, you can see the double helixed DNA strand. Did ancient Indians experiment with genetic engineering and modify DNA? What do you think? I'm Praveen Mohan. Thanks a lot for watching, and I'll talk to you soon. Bye.